Hi, this is Johnny Lee Middleton from the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. We're going to do a rig rundown, and I'm super excited because I got a new rig this year. A couple years ago, I picked up a Bergantino Forte system for my home studio. It sounds so awesome, but I needed a preamp. And Jim came up with the preamp last year. They got it out this year, and this is what I'm bringing to the deck. And we'll take a good look at what I got going here. And the combination of the preamp and the big red tube DI, I send both signals to the house. So he has the ability to take my Bergantino signal that I dirty up a little bit, and we match it with the clean signal, and combined, it really sounds like an amplifier, and the bass really cuts through, nice fat tone. I have the ability to have about 21 different presets in this rig. So I'm running 5 different guitars out here. So each guitar has its own setting, its own EQ, and it is just easy to go through the banks, easy to switch. My tech has no problem going from one guitar to the other. And this thing is super, super, super great to have. Now let's take a look and let's...
Here is the preamp, the Super Pre. And as you can see, we have it labeled for the different basses that I'm using. These are just some of the presets. We're just going to go through a jazz bass setting. This is a 2000 American Deluxe jazz bass. Nothing special, right off the stock, right off the shelf. This is how I have it set. This thing is so great. There's my high pass filters at 40 hertz. My low pass filter is at 4.0 kilohertz. That gives it a nice ampy kind of sound to it. And then I'm running this variable rate compressor on serial. I'm running it pretty hot at 15 and my gain's at 18. That really brings out all the notes. As things get lost in an arena, this thing really finds what gets lost. I do run a little bit of overdrive on it. I like number 6 and I'm only cranking it up to 4. It gives it just enough dirt where when it's combined with this clean signal, it really, really sounds really nice. I really like the feature of being able to have that overdrive on there. This is the crossover on the overdrive, and this is the blend. I'm running it at about 60%. This is my EQ, basically. I'm running my mids a little hot and my low end's a little hot. The mids really cut through. When I crank them up, it really makes the bass cut through in an arena setting. It doesn't get lost in the low end rumble. And that's my loaded jazz bass. Now, if I hold this down, we're going to go into another section of this preamp. And this is if I have an active or passive guitar. I'm running everything passive, so I have a low output instrument. And this is the EQ lines on it. You're at 60, 250, the high mids at 1.0, your trebles at 4.0. And I left this stock. This came this way, and this actually works really good for me. You can adjust it. Go into any one of these presets and change it the way you like it. My tone control, this is what I really dig about this. On my low end, my bass, I got a wide tone control. On my high end treble, I have a real high tone control or wide, but my mids, I really narrowed them out and I could really bring those mids up. And in an arena setting, the bass tends to get lost. So I found that if I really kind of boost the mids a little bit, it really makes a real nice difference and it cuts through really good. My bright filter, I pretty much left it stock. It works really good. I do run it on the bright mode. And of course, we're going to use a post DI select so we get all the goodies that come out of this little box right here. And my scene gain adjustment on this is down to 2 dB. We have an issue trying to keep all the guitars at the same output. This feature allows you to do that and not on the wireless packs themselves. My output level, I don't need to adjust that, so we leave that flat. I'm not running any effects on this gig, so this is all in-ear gig, no effects needed. This is basically for an electric bass. You can switch it for upright. You can switch the impedance selector. I'm running the vintage profile select. I find I'm using flat wound strings, a jazz bass. That vintage profile seems to be the one that works the best for me. And this is how you can load different profiles. We have the little thumb drive right there. We're going to run a main phase as normal, course, and this is your tuner. If you want to, if you tune flatter, you know, you can adjust that. We're at 440 on this gig. And this is, you can import your profiles if you would like, and you can export them to this one, which we did. And if you want to go back to your factory preset, you hit 1, 2, 3, 4. We don't want to do that, so let's get out of there. And that's the Bergantino Audio Super Pre, combined with the Big Red Tube DI. Best bass sound I've had in the 24 years of touring with the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. Great invention. I'm really glad Jim came out with this. This is the most versatile thing I have in my arsenal. I have a lot of amps, a lot of guitars, but this thing right here, get your hands on one of those, especially if you're using in-ears or even not. It's just a great, great thing. 21 different presets. I can have 21 different tones. I could have a tone just for a distorted part if I want to play a bass solo with distortion on it. Not on this gig, maybe another one. That's it. Not much to it.
And the Bergantino Super Pre is all you need for any arena setting, any bar setting, and a studio setting. Probably sound pretty good there. Johnny Lee checking out.